entered in the big league of music with the band called Generation X. After that period, you started a solo career, and your first EP was named Don't Stop. This was a statement of Billy Idol, that after all, nothing can stop Billy Idol from singing?
Well, I don't know about that, but yes, I think it just showed, at that point in my career, it just showed, I was gonna continue on some way or other, yeah.
I know that you were a big fan of Sex Pistols, even member of Brumley contingent. But despite that fact, your musical career was more influenced by Beatles or, I don't know, Rolling Stones. That was a rebel move for you and Generation X to go against the flow?
I don't know about that, really. Me personally, I loved a lot of the 60s groups. You know, The Who and the Beatles and Stones and everybody. It was more like the sort of more of the prog rock that was kind of going on in the 70s that gradually got a bit stale and old, that's all. And also too, it's just we were looking for our own music. You know, we, by the time 1976 came around, you know, we were like nearly 20 years old, and we were just starting to think really about our own music. What are we gonna say?
You're just trying to make your own way in the music.
Yes, yeah, our own version of rock and roll. This is our take on it, you know, our view. I mean, a lot of punk rock, even though it was you know, even though it had lots of different elements to it, it was still using the basic instrumentation of early rock and roll. And in fact, I looked personally back to people in the 50s, the earliest rock and roll music, Little Richard and Jerry Lee Lewis and people like that, just as much as I looked at, say, The Clash or The Pistols. You know, I looked backwards for inspiration. I mean, there had been a punk rock movement in the early 60s in America, and we were looking back to that. Now, there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that music, you know. The Seeds, or there was a load of bands from America making punk rock music. I mean, you know, so I wasn't against the Sex Pistols or the Clash. I believed in what we were doing. I believed in what they were saying. It's just I didn't believe exactly in No Beatles, Elvis, and Rolling Stones in the same way they did. Personally, the Beatles had broken up and were over. Elvis had died.
And everything
the just Rolling Stones kind of reinvented themselves with some girls. I didn't feel so bad about them. To me, it was more like the big, bloated, progressive rock bands like Emerson, Lake and Palmer and groups like that. That's who I was pissed off about. You know, these big groups, you know, and I don't know, this element of I don't know. I wanted rock and roll to get back to being simple, you know, back to being
back,
you know,
to the roots, something like that.
You know, contained music. That's what we were all looking for, really, in punk rock. And there's just different ways of expressing how you wanted to do that. And we were Generation X. We weren't the Clash and the Pistols. We had a different viewpoint. That's all. But we agreed with the Clash and the Pistols. It's just I just thought, yeah, you know, Elvis is all died in 1977, really. The Beatles had broken up for 7 years by 1977, and I thought the Stones kind of reinvented themselves. But I love the sort of, you know, the beginnings of rock and roll. I love the beginnings of the Rolling Stones, the beginnings of the Beatles. The Beatles in Hamburg, that's who I loved, you know. I love that, you know, like, I loved it when people, it was this kind of simple, not simple, but this primitive music. That's what I liked.
Now let's go to the year of 1984. The album Rebel Yell was a rebel yell of the 80s generation?
Well, it was actually, I really wrote that song about women, actually. It was a cry of love, an orgasmic, sexual cry of love. And it was about how great women are. That's, and, you know, the rebel women have a place they can go in their bodies that's so much more deeper than ours, in a sense, sexually. And I was really singing about that, you know, about how great women are and how sometimes it's really heavy. We men, we have to sort of like go deep to get in touch with that, you know, with with the woman, female orgasm, you know. So Rebel Yell is really about the cry of love, you know, really, that's what that was about.
The inspiration was a party, I know. No, a party held by Rolling Stones, if I remember well.
Yes, they were drinking bottles of this southern sour mash, this bourbon called Rebel Yell. And I was making my album at the time, and I just thought, that's a great title. Wow, that could be a great title for me. And I asked them straight out, because I said, did you get this bottle made up? You know, did you get this made for you? And they said, no, you can buy it down south in America. It's a southern sour mash. And I said, well, are you going to use that name as a song or anything? You know, and they kind of looked at each other, Mick and Keith and Ronnie looked at each other and kind of went, wow. And as they were looking at each other, I kind of said, well, you've got Street Fighting Man and you've got Jumping Jack Flash, Rebel Yell. They kind of went, no, we probably wouldn't use that. And I went, fantastic, cause I can use that, you know. And so it was really nice of them. And they didn't say don't use it or anything, you know, they were great. So it was fantastic, really, getting a bit of inspiration straight from the Rolling Stones. How incredible.
From the Rolling Stones and straight from the bottle.
Straight from the bottle, yes, sir.
This year you'll release the first new album in almost a decade. It will be in the same style of Billy Idol, or we should expect from something different?
Well, I think it will be in the style of Billy Idol, but I do hope that in some ways people will feel that we've kind of extended what we've done before, that we have gone beyond the boundaries of what we've done before. And but, you know, all Billy Idol albums, they really do cover massive ground in terms of all the different elements of songs we do. We don't just do one type of music. We really don't. We've always prided ourselves, me and Steve Stevens, I think we've always prided ourselves on the fact that we play quite an eclectic form of music. It's not just one type of music. It's rock and roll, yes, but inside of that, we're doing ballads, we're doing punk rock songs, we're doing rock and roll songs, we're doing groove music, we're doing sex music, we're doing dance music. I think there's so many factors that I was able to put into my music once I went solo, you know.
Also this year, I know that you released your autobiography, Dancing With Myself. I have to ask you if this was always the same, Billy Idol, I don't know, the Lonely Wolf, in a perpetuum solo dance with life.
Well, it wasn't how I started out. I mean, I really wanted to be just in a group, really. But, you know, Billy Idol itself, you know, with me and Steve Stevens and Billy Morrison in the group and McGee, my bass player, has been in the group for now 15 years. This is a group. It very much is. It's a solo career, yes, but it's a group as well. And I think that's what's great. We've kind of combined. We've got both things going on. We've got, it's not just me on my own, it really is, I've got the best of both worlds. That's really what I was looking for, a great group, but something that was inspired by me, you know, in terms of the music. I mean, the book is more about my life, so
yeah, of course.
That's why it's Dancing With Myself. It's I'm really talking primarily about me and what motivated me, what gave me ideas, my life, really. So in terms of the book, it's very much about me as a person.
And the last thing, can you send a message for all Romanian fans?
Well, I'm just looking forward to having a really fantastic time. So this tour has been a lot of fun. The audiences have been crazy. So I know the Romanians are a nutty crowd. They're really crazy too. And I just can't wait to play for them. We've got a great group. We've got a great we've got a great lineup. We've got a great selection of songs, and we'll be playing a few new songs, not too many at the moment as the record isn't out, but I'm very excited, and I think that's the best thing I can say to the Romanian audience. I'm coming there. I'm really excited to be there. We've also been playing now for over a month. We're in the fifth week of this tour or whatever. We will be in the fifth week of this tour by the time we get to Romania. This band is really firing on all cylinders, and I think they're going to see a great Billy Idol show.